हरि ओम नमस्ते. टुडे द सेशंस दैट हैव बीन पोस्टपोन्ड फ्रॉम यस्टरडे इवनिंग विल बी द फर्स्ट वंस. दिस सेशन वाज प्लान्ड फॉर यस्टरडे इवनिंग. द सेशन इज कॉल्ड पोएट्री इन स्टोन. दिस इज द स्कल्पचर्स. द पेपर्स आर ऑन स्कल्पचर्स. The cultural program was getting delayed yesterday, so we thought we had to give the stage to the folk singer and the dancer, so we had to cut short. The papers of yesterday that have been postponed to today. This session has two papers. One is on Modhera, the other is on Shashikant ji is covering Mahabharata Yatra. The village, the whole village goes on a yatra inside the village itself for a given number of days, usually around 20 to 40 days, to perform Mahabharata. The whole village participates in Mahabharata performance. This is about that yatra. And he has made a film called Kelai Draupadi. This is a Tamil Nadu tradition. Shashikant ji is a highly senior photography person, cultural researcher, cultural documentation specialist. He is bringing Mahabalipuram sculptures into life by shooting all the Mahabalipuram sculptures and then making them through his graphical, digital graphic work. He is giving them color and bringing three-dimensional picturization for them. Recently, he has finished a Hoysala heritage tour also. He has brought all the panels of Hoysala Mahabharata, Hoysala Ramayana, and he is bringing all the Hoysala frames back into life. Even if the sculptures are broken, he is fulfilling them, and he is making the whole story of the Hoysala pictures. So, Sri Shashikant ji is going to now talk about Mahabharata performance, yatra inside the village. The whole village goes for a yatra.
Okay. Yeah, sorry for the disturbance. So I'm going to be speaking about the, there's a very interesting yatra in Tamil Nadu called the Mahabharata Kutuvila. So basically it happens in a place called the Dharmaraja temple. And the story is that Dharmaraja is never taken out as a Urchava Murti. So it's only Draupadi who is taken out. Because Dharmaraja, people, the belief is that Dharmaraja shouldn't see Kali Yuga, which is outside. So Dharmaraja is only inside the temple and Draupadi is taken to all the performance spaces. So the entire the story is that Draupadi is the festival is performed so that Draupadi can hear her own story again. And I first saw this in 1999 when I was shooting for somebody else, and it was a theatre person from Delhi who was making a documentation of Therukoothu, and it was a 40-night performance, but in the day something else was happening. And that intrigued me. So it's 20 hours a day they perform. In the night, the Mahabharata is performed as Kutu. In the afternoon, it's narrated as a story. And in the morning, they do it as village rituals. So by doing it as a, in the morning, they do it as village rituals. Okay, so it's a three levels of performance. And all these levels, they contradict. Okay, and there is, that is part of the thing. So Mahabharata is never told, it is invoked. So it's a Mahabharata in you, which you have to, okay. So, and it starts from a very simple thing. The writer, Viliputrar, has his fight with his younger brother. Okay, and both are very good poets. So play in the festival starts from there. So he goes to his king and he says that, please settle the property dispute. So King Varavari Kondan respects both the brothers as poets. And he wants to defer. He doesn't want to side with one brother against the other. So he says, please both of you write the Mahabharatam. And after you write the Mahabharatam, I'll settle your property dispute. So the brothers accept and they go to write the Mahabharatam. And when they're writing the Mahabharatam, they realized that that's what they're writing about, property dispute. And they settled their this thing. And but other thing which Viluputtarar says is that I'm a Vishnu Bhakt. I'll only write portions where Vishnu is there. Okay, and so only 10 sargams they write. So when he's asked to perform, recite the Bharatam, people say that it's not Bharatam. Okay, where is the Ganapati Suti before the Bharatam? So Viluputtarar's son, who is there in the auditorium, gets up and he says, my father wrote that, but he forgot it. So the father-son problem, the entire, what do you say, brother's problem is resolved. And that is why the Mahabharatam is performed here, to build a community of belonging. So there are, what do you say, each chadi in the village is assigned a certain, they take up a certain kind of a ritual which they sponsor. And they feed, thousands of people come there. So it is that jadi's responsibility to feed the entire community who comes there. In a village, they don't have one. And this is about 300, 400 villages. Okay, I'll start with the first video, which is the beginning of the film, where it's not alone the Mahabharata is invoked. In this entire festival, Draupadi is always called as a sister of Rama. So when you are, what do you say, narrating the Mahabharata, you're also invoking the Ramayana. So that is the first video which I'll play. So this is the premise that this Mahabharata and Ramayana and are all seen as stories of exile. And the entire village goes into exile during this performance. So it, even their own village, they are, what do you say, outside in the field. It's 20 hours a day, that's a performance. Okay, and it is a say, for the killing of Bakasura, Bhima has to carry food to Baka. So the entire village gets up in the early in the morning, cooks food. And Bhima and Bakasura go to each village, collect the food, and to take to, and finally, at the end of the, in the field, Bakasura is killed by Bhima. So every ritual, the villagers inscribe themselves. So they don't become just observers. They're also the actors of the Mahabharata. Okay, so the Mahabharata is both inside oneself and outside oneself in the way it is performed. So the Kiratarjunyam, that is the other, it starts from the Pallava period. Na? The Pallava, that's a huge story, but it is this entire festival started with the Pallava Chalukya war, and there are memories of that very strongly there. And Kiratarjunyam, which is what you say, one of the major Arjuna's penance, which is one of the major rituals here, is what you say, seen all over South India. And there is a story of how it goes from, it starts from actually the Chalukya, comes to Mamallapuram, then from here it goes into the Hoysala, and then it comes to Vijayanagara. And these are the most beautiful depictions of Kiratarjunyam. I wanted to play that video, but it's too long, so I would shift it there. But this three levels of performance is what is interesting, actually, in a sense that the Kutu, the storytellers, will contest that this is not the Mahabharata, with the Kutu people say. That they say that you people are illiterate, you do not know the Mahabharata. And the ritual, the village is the final arbiter, because they are giving the money to the, and the, so they'll say that this is the Mahabharata. So it is, but the Mahabharata is, everybody has to reconstruct for themselves at that point of time. So it becomes a journey for each one who is participating. So the closest example I can give, and also that the villages when they hire, they don't, every year the Mahabharata is performed, but every year the performance is different. Because they hire one Kutu group this time, which have a certain tradition of performance. They'll hire a different storyteller who has a different, what do you say, they have say, certain things which are unique to them. So, and this mix up, every it's like you hear Malkons of Bhimsen Joshi, next year you hear it from somebody else. So, at the end of 20 years, you have an idea of Malkons which is, encompasses all these performers, the folk, the classical, this and that actually. So, that is the experience which is there. So, it's not a, unipolar text, it's a, what do you say, it's a cumulative understanding. So, you also remember yourself listening to the Mahabharata. So that is the kind of experience which is there, which I'm, this is the immersive, what do you say, experience of the Mahabharata, which is what stunned me and which is why I spent about 10 years following this up actually. So, and I finally I'll come to the last ritual. So the people will say it's, here Duryodhana has to be killed, okay, and so the entire thing is, here the, all the three layers of the festival come together, the storytellers, the Kutu performers, and the, everything is there, and it's in a single, it's a ritual, storytelling, and a theater. Okay, that is, this is the climax of the festival, I'll just go to that.
Yeah.
Thank you. That is the. So basically, this the anti-war thing is where it starts. To build a community of belonging is what the Mahabharata is being used for, and has been used for 1300 years. Okay. It has become bigger. There are about 150 groups right now, so the Kutu groups, and there are 100 groups of storytellers. It's happening in a big fashion, and more number of villages are doing it. As a modern artist, if for my documentary films or my films, I'll be happy if 100 people come and watch the screening. Here there are thousands of people, so which is why I hope this works. Is an interesting story. Why people are 10,000 people are there, and the village is feeding 10,000 people there on its own. And it happens 50 kilometers from Madras, and people in Madras do not know about it, which is really terrible actually. So this is the if you go into each and every aspect, and the level of understanding of the epic is also fabulous. It's not like it's a different kind of a. I showed it in Kurukshetra, a village near Kurukshetra, and they said they duplicate Mahabharata. Amara original. They got very angry. He said, "How can people in Tamil Nadu perform the Mahabharata?" So immediately they called their performers, and then they said, "What do you want us to perform?" It was a challenge. I said, "Whatever you like performing." So they performed Karna's dialogue with Kunti. So I said, when I first started doing research for this, I asked the Kutu people to perform something from Kutu. So and they said, "What do you want us to perform?" I said, "Whatever you like performing." They performed Karna's dialogue with Kunti. I said, so in terms of emotionally, the connect is there actually. Okay, so anyhow, any questions?
Wonderful. Congratulations.
Thank you.
A brilliant presentation. I'm fascinated by the selection of Kiratarjuni. What is your interpretation? I mean, what's the place it holds? Of course, in Sanskrit Mahakavya, it is a gem. But in folk tradition also that it is reflected. How do you account for this?
No, it is coming directly from the Pallava thing. We'll speak about it outside, because it is the Pallava, they trace the ancestry from Ashwatthaman. So there is a long story about it. Why they trace the ancestry to Ashwatthaman is in a certain tradition, Ashwatthaman, after he goes into exile, he's supposed to return back and he's supposed to become the next Vyasa of the Kali Yuga. So the Pallava, the Mahabharata tradition in Tamil Nadu seems to come from the Pallava period. But that some scholar has to do a real kind of thing, but it is there. In Vaikuntha Perumal temple, you will see the entire genealogy of the Pallavas, which is depicted there as panels. And the narrative panels come from the first narrative panels which are there of the Pallava period are Kiratarjunyam, and that is also what is being performed in the Kutu. And this Kutu is directly, the Raja addresses Potraja. Potraja is a name by which the Pallava king was called. Even Duryodhana will be called Potraja.
Yeah, that is also the name used for Kadak Lakshmi in Maharashtra. Potraja,
The Potraja is the Pallava, that Kadak Lakshmi ritual is very close, is all over South India, and it comes from the Pallava period.
Okay,
it is there. That same thing about they carry around and one person will sing.
Yes.
It is there in Tamil. I'll show you an image of that. So we have been following that actually. We've been traveling around various versions of Potraja
Is that why it is more prominent in the Tondai Mandalam, the Pallava region?
Yeah.
It's not seen very much in South Tamil Nadu.
No, it is there. It is there in a different, and I think the Pallava thing, I have shot it in Kanyakumari. But it's a different version. So Tondai Mandalam, it is very vibrant. It is there in this thing also. It is there in Kerala, it's Karnataka. They do it with Yakshagana in South Karnataka, and Andhra, South Andhra, it's there. So you travel to the entire thing, but it is there is a difference always. Okay, thank you.